All right. Hello, parents and families. I am so delighted to be here with all of you today. And along with me, I have colleagues from the Dining Center. We welcome you to Cal Maritime, the Keelhauler family. My name is Vineeta Dhillon. Currently, I serve as the new Students and Family Program Director, which means that I am your liaison here at Cal Maritime. You've likely seen my Facebook posts if you've joined us there. And going forward, I'll be the person that you can call with questions or to get in touch for any reason. And I might not have all the answers, but I will find the right contact for you on campus and get you connected. You'll always reach me live, or almost always. I will, in a few minutes, put my phone number in chat, so you can text me or call me if you need anything moving forward. Thank you again for being here with us this evening. I have a few housekeeping items for our hour together, so that we are mindful and able to move along what my colleagues have prepared for you this evening. Please keep your devices on mute during this presentation. You will have an opportunity to ask questions at the end of today's presentation. Please write those questions in chat, whether you do it during the presentation or once it opens up for Q&A, either works. I will read them out when we open the floor for Q&A, and my colleagues will present their answers to those questions. If you're not able to, for any reason, provide your questions in writing, the last few minutes, we'll open it up for you to unmute and verbally ask your questions. So hold that thought. We'll make it happen towards the end. If you're looking for very specific details that pertain to your student, we'd love for you to not share too many details in this open forum. Don't hesitate to reach one of the presenters or to me. The best way to do that is orientation@csum.edu email, and we'll get back with you. If you think of something after this call and want to reach any one of us, same email, orientation@csum.edu, and we'll get back with you. We're going to try to focus on nutrition, meal plans, food, the dining center, everything related to yummy stuff. And if you have unrelated to food and meal plan questions, please look at your schedule for presentations that'll continue through the next 6 weeks, 4 weeks, and hold your questions for that particular topic. Or again, feel free to email us at orientation@csum.edu. And with that, it is my distinct pleasure to invite my colleagues from Sodexo and our own dining center to introduce themselves and take us through their presentation. So Karen and Scott, welcome, and please take it away.
Okay. Well, welcome everybody. My name is Karen Goble, and I'm in charge of the marketplace or anything to do with any of your future cadets' dietary wants and needs, okay? So welcome aboard, and hopefully we will be able to get through this fairly quickly, but more importantly, be able to get any questions that you might have that are still pending answered for you, all right?
And hello,
all right, everyone. Okay, go ahead, Scott.
I'm sorry to step on you there, Karen. I just wanted to say hello before Karen gets going. My name is Scott Kern, and I'm with Cal Maritime Corporation. And I just want to welcome every one of you to our family. And I want you to know that you are in wonderful professional hands with Karen and her team at the dining center. And please proceed, Karen. Thank you.
Thank you for that, Scott. Okay, so Marketplace is where all of your cadets will be coming down to eat. But we want to make sure that you know that we are foremost concentrated on fresh ingredients with any kind of healthy options. We want to make sure that we are being socially and environmentally sound and responsible, and that we would be able to meet any kind of, for the most part, any kind of dietary needs that you might have. But the trick of the whole piece is being able to know that. So as we go through this, just keep in mind that the more communication that your cadet can come and bring myself and my team, the better off that we're all gonna be, okay? This is in my team, just so you guys have an understanding on kind of who it is on site here that will be helping support your cadet. That's myself up in the top left-hand corner there. My operations manager, Orlando, you'll always see him on the floor all around the campus. Chef Mark is where the key to all of our fresh and good ingredients come from. He also is really all on top of being out in the dining room, in the marketplace, being able to make those connections with the cadets, trying to figure out what it is that sparks their tastes, their values, and what their wants and needs are. And then we have two other supporting people in Bianca and Jasmine that support a lot behind the scenes, whether it's from a retail standpoint, or we do a lot of catering here on campus. And so Jasmine would be somebody that you might coordinate with something of that nature. All right, so how in the world do we end up paying for all this? And I know that I paid this money up for my cadet to be able to eat. Where are those dollars, how are those dollars located? Where is it that they can spend their money? How are they gonna be able to get fed this whole time? All of that is through their port pass. So their port pass would also balance out as their meal card. It works as a declining balance. So they will be able to come and eat at the marketplace, the Morro Cove Market, which does more. Let me back up. The marketplace will suit most of their hot, immediate food needs. Okay. We use the marketplace not only to be able to feed our cadets, but it's a good socialization environment for them to come in, socialize with each other, have a hot meal, be able to grab a cup of coffee and kind of lounge and be able to enjoy their dinner or breakfast or whatever they look like. The Morro Cove Market is geared more towards things that are to-go items, meaning if maybe I have a real bad craving for cereal in the middle of the night, we'll sell them a box of cereal and a container of milk, or if they have little snacks or things that they want to need, or anything to do with food that would be a to-go kind of situation, you would find that in the Morro Cove Market. We have a bistro, which operates similar to like a Starbucks. We operate, in fact, a pretty robust Starbucks menu out of that. Your DCB dollars also will take care of any kind of special events. We've got a lot of special events on campus, in addition to the food trucks that we try to bring in at least once a month, to kind of break up the monotony of only, you know, of always being able to go into the marketplace and that kind of thing. If you have any questions, you're always welcome to go to the Cal Maritime site. And on the dining page is the link that is below there and explains a little bit more about the meal plan and how all of that works. So what is DCB? We talked about declining balance just a minute ago. On their port pass, they will go and they will use their funds in order to be able to purchase their meals. They have everybody starts off with $2,800. Now, throughout as they're going and they're purchasing, they will have a screen that pops up and they will tell them exactly how much that they have left after they have purchased those needs for the day. So if they go and they spend, you know, $5, it will have a screen that'll pop up after they have finished and it says $27.95 remaining on your balance. Your balance from fall will roll over to your spring semester. However, it's really important for them, everybody, to remember that the money from your DCB does not roll over from spring to your following fall. So it's going to be important not only for your cadet to be able to manage their funds well, but to make sure that they, you know, towards the end of the semester, especially next spring, that they know ahead of time, hey, I've got an extra $50 that I'm not sure that I'm going to spend, and that they can go and treat themselves to that extra Starbucks coffee or whatever that treat that might be for them. Okay. It also will make it so they can, it will average out to approximately $26 a day to spend for three meals. On days of Saturday and Sunday, we just do brunch and then dinner. However, we have found that most cadets do sleep in fairly late, but then they come and they have a large amount for brunch. So they would generally eat a heavier meal during the brunch period. These are some items that we will share throughout the marketplace. You will have different food service coming out of each one of these things. Everything from a grilled burger to pizza to something healthy and light to be able to take care of their needs if they are on a high protein diet, if they're an athlete and needing to really watch, make sure that they're getting extra carbs or whatever that might intake. We have a new feature this year called Chef Stage Center, where a couple of the days a week, we will actually have Chef Mark out in the middle of the marketplace, and he will take ownership of whatever that special is that day, give him an opportunity to meet with the cadets and have it be a little bit something that's probably a little more high end. We do serve a lot of Kika sushi. We try to make sure that there's SubHub available. SubHub is basically like our made to order deli, where your cadet can go online and use an app to be able to pick out whatever that they would like on their sandwich, everything from the bread to the veggies, the type of meat that it is. We have our salad bar, fresh salad bar coming back. So again, they would be able to come and choose whatever it is that they want on their salad, what kind of dressing they want, the different types of lettuce, types of veggies, and that sort of thing. And then I'm going to turn it over to Kelsey, who helps work with me on the marketing aspect, and ask Kelsey to walk us through the My T-Text app. This will be something that'll be good not only for the cadets, but for you as parents as well. Kelsey?
Hello. Hi, everyone. My name's Kelsey. Like Karen said, I help support dining services on campus with marketing communications. So we're really big on communications and keeping not just cadets, not just our campus, but also all of you folks involved, being parents. And, one of the things that we have and we're so excited about, and it's always a huge success. We've been doing this for quite a few semesters now, quite a few years, is My D-Texts. So this is not another app that you need to download or anything. This is just a way that your cadets and you as parents or family members, loved ones, you can connect with us in real time. And how this works is you text Dine Maritime. So that's the message itself. You write the word Dine Maritime with no spaces. And I'll put this in chat too, to the number 82257. And this information also lives on our website. And like I said, I'll share this in chat. But if you just text us, this text, whether it be assistance or, feedbacks, comments, questions, suggestions, whatever it may be, this goes to our general manager, Karen. This goes to our operations manager, Orlando.
You can have a seat somewhere, and then when I go to the counter, can you?
Hi.
Can we please keep our devices on mute? Thank you very much. We'd really appreciate that.
Thank you. I think it automatically joins the call without being on mute. Yeah, that happened with me earlier. So like I was saying, my detext, you know, it's real time. It goes to, you know, the managers on our team, even our executive chef, Chef Mark. He's able to see this right away. And this has been so beneficial for just, you can think of the reasons. To give you some examples, you know, if your cadet's at the soda machine in the marketplace and, you know, the Coke is not really tasting so good, the syrup's running out or something, just send us a quick text and we're all right there on site and we can go refill that. Hey, soda machine's a little, it's kind of tasting flat or what have you. Or, hey, you know, send us a text saying it's Thanksgiving. What are your hours? Are you open? Boom. And of course we try and do as much as we can. We have digital monitor screens all throughout the marketplace. And, you know, we do so much more too, announcing things at formation. The campus helps us out with things like, you know, Thanksgiving Day hours and so have you. But your cadets, they're going to be very busy. And I know schedules are really tight. So this is just kind of one of those things, instead of having to search online, you just text us. If you have feedback, or if they have feedback, your cadets, comments, suggestions, something like, hey, love the pulled pork sandwiches. Next time you do that, could you guys offer jalapenos on the side or something like that? And so, like I said, this goes to the whole team. We talk about it. We usually bring it up at our daily staff huddles, and it's just, it just elevates the whole experience for all. And on top of that, it's also anonymous. So we're trying, and we've been trying, and we do pride ourselves on creating and just having this culture of feedback. So we want to hear it, good or bad. Like, we really want to hear both equally. I mean, even I would even say we want to hear what you didn't like. So then that way we can, you know, maybe do, I don't know, you know, we could do quesadillas without this type of cheese, or just something small. And it only helps us, and it makes us feel good that cadets are engaged and involved and making it better, not just for them, but for their peers as well. So like I said, this is not exclusive to cadets. Parents, we encourage and invite you to text us at any time. Once again, you text 82257, that's the number. And then in the body of the text, which will opt you in, it's Dine Maritime, one word. And just to hit also on the feedback that we always take and we do stuff with it, right? We plan out our programs, and we have decided about the stations that Karen mentioned based on, you know, we have a huge student athlete population. So we wanted to do something with clean eats, right? Something that doesn't have a lot of fillers, or, you know, it's not the pizza station. So have you. But also in feedback, besides my detext, which is super simple, and if you have your phone now and you're able to, you can even just text us right now just so that you have that saved in your messages. But we also take a lot of feedback and respond as quickly as we can in a couple other ways. And that would be on social media. We're very engaged on Instagram. And I'll put this in chat as well. You can find us at Cal Maritime Marketplace. And I think that if you have an Instagram, or even if you don't, that is the place that you can really see pictures and vibe, the whole vibe, and just pictures of food and pictures of events and giveaways and things that we do. So social media, you can always just send us a direct message. You can walk into Karen's office on the second floor. Your cadets can walk in, or you could just have a conversation with the person serving food at, like I said, the pizza station or something. Like, hey, have you guys ever thought about doing a pesto pizza? Okay, that feedback always gets back to the team. And then of course there's our website, and through that you can also email us. So we just want to ensure you that we're tuned in and we're ready, and we're looking forward to hearing all the questions or comments that you have.
Thank you, Kelsey.
Thank you.
One of the things that is really important to this generation, to in fact, more than this generation, is the fact that we are definitely trying to be local and sustainable. And so we just wanted to share some information with you regarding where we currently are sourcing the food for your cadets from. We try to make sure that everything is within a sustainable amount of space. Any produce or anything of that nature does not come up any more than 150 miles from the campus. And we're actually trying to work currently with being able to get local farmers that were even within, a smaller radius like Coke Farms. And we advertise that too, so your cadet will know, hey, look, your broccoli that you're eating today, it is a locally sourced product. And that's why it tastes so good and so fresh. We think that it's also important to be able to have a little fun while we're here. So while we have our normal stuff that we offer on an everyday basis, there's also promotions, pop-ups. We do everything from food trucks to make your own hot chocolate bars when it comes to time when it's cold outside. Gives them an opportunity to be able to just come in, not only have good food, but, recharge and be able to catch up with their friends. And this is just a couple of examples of what that looks like. These were taken from last semester, and so that way, it's after you eat the same thing over and over, it gets a little boring. So we have to mix it up and try and offer lots and lots of variety. This is a couple of examples of just some, community day that we had last spring. Some of the events that came forth and that the students were able to again use their DCB money. They came in, they paid for dinner, and then it was something way different, whether it was a fancy dessert or all kinds of different appetizers, and just again just something to provide community and socialization. The three gentlemen that are down in the middle corner are all folks that had done videos, which Kelsey had talked a little bit about Instagram, but had videos where they had cooking with Joey, or they, the other two gentlemen had their own little cooking show, and they used it. They used products where we put a little video on Instagram to show the rest of the cadets on campus of different things that they made in their rooms, providing different products that we sold here at the marketplace and in the new Morro Cove market, using just the equipment that they could have inside their rooms. So every once in a while, if you want something different, or Joey, for instance, loves to cook, he was able to show you a good way that you could use your DCB money, but still enjoy a little bit of cooking. And Kelsey, if you could go ahead and talk a little bit about some of the promotions we did real quick.
Yeah, so we work with our vendors, to get as much giveaways and keep it fun and fresh. And, these are exclusive giveaways to cadets that are on campus in the moment. And we usually do these on Instagram, but it was really cool. We have as you can see, the Nike duffel bag giveaway that was sponsored by Gatorade. And even Cheetos gave away a bike, which I still see on campus. So we always just try and keep it fun, keep it kind of spicy and not mundane. And if there's, promotions and celebrations, we're definitely going to bring it.
Couple of the other things that we do on campus, there's a thing called Thursday Nights on the Patio, and they are, it's really great. Generally, there's some kind of music, a band will play. The cadets can come out and they can have something, again, that's a little bit different just from the normal stuff that they get in the marketplace all the time. So they'd be able to get appetizers, or they would, whatever the Commandant normally sponsors something, so they can have something a little bit different. One of the new things that we're trying this year is called Late Night on the Patio. So we're going to start off you know, at the couple of nights a week where we, the marketplace will stay open later so that they can come out and socialize and then be able to get, you know, have a hamburger, have something that's different, and really focus just that socialization out on the patio, enjoying the sunlight out on the water for as long as we can get it to last. And then we'll move it a little bit inside come towards the, you know, winter months and be able to do some other fun things later at night. I talked a little bit about the bistro earlier. It is pretty much similar to just a regular Starbucks bistro. We offer a lot of Starbucks same menu prices. It's open Monday through Friday from 6:30 to 2. Lot of folks come in and take advantage of that. You know, during formation, they come in and get their latte before they go to their formation, and then they'll come over to the marketplace for
breakfast. I thought this started at 5:30. Why is it already on?
I'm sorry.
Tell Dhillon to come down here. Maybe he wants to watch it too, because it's talking about, I don't know, Starbucks. Yeah. Go under parents, Cal. Go under parents, then go under orientation.
We could get everybody to mute and we'll be able to answer questions in just a few minutes.
Oh, sorry.
Starbucks. Yeah, the bistro.
One of the things. Heard my mute. Oops, sorry.
One of the things that we do, because a lot of times with their busy schedules, a cadet will want a little, you know, they'll want a little part-time job because they want to be able to have a little extra spending money or whatever that might entail. We do offer some employment opportunities. And one of the great things about working for us is that, hey, we're right here close on campus. But in addition to that, we will work completely around the cadet's schedule. So if the cadet has a big exam or something like that coming up, they can come let us know. We'll make sure that they have time to take off to study, to be able to concentrate, you know, on the true reason that we're here. One of the things that you as a parent might want to know about is we have a little thing where you can send love from home. And what that looks like is there's different pieces and packages that you can send over to Cal Maritime Dining. And it's as simple as just sending us an email saying, hey, I know that my son's got a big exam tomorrow. I'd like to send him a box of cookies or whatever that, you know, something different that he might not have, but he's missing home for whatever that is. And that's something that you can contact us. We'll get it all ready to go. Make sure there's a note attached to it, you know, with love from you. And so that way they know, hey, mom and dad are thinking about me today, or Aunt Mary's thinking about me today. And so whether it's a birthday or just any other day, just let you know that's something that we do offer. Here's an example of some of the care packages that you might be able to send. And it's everything from, you know, a birthday cake with their name on it to a pizza party for some of their friends. We will do something that's customized specifically towards your cadet if we have all the details. And again, you just need to send that to calmaritime.usa.sodexo.com. And all of this information is on our website as well. So you'll be able to pull it from there. We do ask just that we get some 72 hours worth of leeway time, just to be able to make sure that we can get all the product in to be able to take care of your order. And then we just want to let you know too, that we have the way that we completely form our menu and everything else has to do with feedback from the cadets. So the food committee meets once a month. There is a group of cadets that go and they seek feedback from other folks on campus. And then they come and they work with myself and my chef and the rest of the team in order to be able to make changes. So just to make sure that you know that if you're hearing something like, hey, look, I wasn't able to find anything for dinner last night or whatever that might look like, they've got several resources that they can go to. You know, they can contact somebody that's on the food committee. They can join the food committee and be part of that themselves. We do welcome anybody to be able to do that. There is, they can always contact me or the chef. They've got the detex, my detex that they can use. I put up here some, you know, my telephone number, my direct telephone number, and then other resources that are on the Cal Maritime site that will be able to get us to some, the dining services area, but the more communication, the better. So if you could just really encourage your child to be able to come and talk to us, we'll be able to get anything solved that you know, that their wants or needs might be. Okay. And then is Travis on? We decided that we'd invite Travis to come on. Travis is a cadet that's already here. And
yep, I'm right here.
Okay, wonderful. Welcome, Travis. So I'll just turn it over to you for a couple of minutes and then we'll take the questions.
Hello, everyone. My name is Travis Lieberman. I'm a fourth year global studies student, and I'm also a member of the Associated Students of Cal Maritime. I'm kind of here to give my kind of overall impressions of dining services and stuff like that. You know, I'm sure some of you have been to college as well. It's, I would say since we have a much smaller campus, our dining center staff is absolutely great, but it's nothing like, you know, a parent's home cooked meal on campus. You're going to get, always going to get reliable food. You're going to get many great options. And, you know, if something's not great, they're happy to take your opinions with the food committee. I know personally, a lot of students are students that have served on the food committee and have your son or daughter talk to them if they have an idea about, you know, if they want something or, you know, think something could be improved upon, talk to them and they'll bring it up to the meeting. I know I've talked to them and I've seen changes to the dining center. So it's just not, you know, an echo chamber of ideas. They'll actually talk about your ideas and try to improve the campus. The dining center staff is absolutely great. We see them out there all day, every day, putting their, you know, absolute best foot forward, serving the cadets from everything from the main dining center to the bistro. I personally love going to the bistro and getting, you know, a cup of coffee after formation in the morning, right before I go to class, if I have time. One thing I will have to say though, is my personal recommendation to your son or daughter going to Cal Maritime is, you know, keep on track of that $26, because if you're not spending money, you will end up at the end of the year with $800, sometimes even $1,000 left. I've known people that have had almost $1,800 left to spend, and they have to pack, you know, because they don't want that money going to waste. They have to pack $1,800 with their bulk items, water, snacks, food into the car, returning home. And that's never a fun trip. So try to stick to as close as $26 a day as possible. Always stock up on snacks, water, my little canned coffees if you want in your room. I always recommend buying a ton of the bottled water to keep up in your room, because there's not many water bottle refilling stations on campus. It's just a great thing to have if you get thirsty at night. That's my recommendation. Stick to as close as that $26 limit. Again, I'll bring it back to Karen.
Okay, well, I think we're ready for some Q&A at this point. So, Vineeta, do you want to go ahead and go through the questions in the chat and we can go and do some answers?
Sure, but I want to take a second to thank you and Travis and Scott, if he's still on the call, for bringing us all this information, and especially Travis for sharing his cadet perspective on how things happen on campus. And that we're always trying to improve and support our cadets when they're here. With that, I actually created a little bit of confusion because I accidentally wrote $27 versus $26. So the correct amount on that is 26, Karen, correct?
It is correct.
Okay, yes. Thank you both. I'm not seeing very many other questions. The only other question I have is, can you explain why there's only one plan option and why any remaining balance does not get refunded in spring?
Okay, well, the way the declining balance plan got started was the advisory committee met and came up with the plan. So the plan in and of itself actually came directly from the student body at the time. They were the ones that created it and said, this is what we're wanting to do. We want to make sure that we are able to get fed, that we feel like $26 a day is a fair amount to be able to do that. They are the majority of folks that are here on campus have very, very rigid and physical programs that they are in. And it is very concerning when somebody does have a lot of money left over because it says that they're not eating. And in order to be able to build up the energy that they need to be able to make it through, you know, all the physical parts of their schooling, it makes it so that they need to be able to eat that much. When the plan was originally put into place, as far as not having it go and roll over, that was the decision that was made. I'm gonna, Scott, if you know more information as to why it doesn't continue to roll over, I'll direct to you because I don't know that piece.
It's just a policy that was established. And just to reiterate what Karen's saying, we touch base with students on a quarterly, monthly, whatever basis that we feel we need. Once we recognize that there's a higher balance on any given account than there ought to be, we touch base to make sure people are getting proper nutrition, that they're not having any issues that, you know, need other attention, and you know, that they're remaining healthy. As far as the money, it's just the policy that's been here. It precedes my arrival here, and I don't know the background to it other than I know it was all established originally through the council, as you mentioned.
I can tell you too that it was actually when a lot of campuses were increasing their amount, we actually decreased ours. It did average out to about, I believe, $34 a day, and they took it down to $26. To speak to what Scott had just mentioned, there we run a report. I personally run a report every month, and the bottom 10% of folks that if we don't have their spend down to where it really needs to be at that point in time, they do get a phone call just to find out, you know, kind of what's going on. And it's been various things. Some of it we've been able to change and be able to make an accommodation for, regarding maybe if somebody that is strictly on a vegan diet and they need a little bit more variety and things like that. But overall, they're not spending that $26 a day, there's some reason for concern.
Karen, you just touched on vegan. Could you speak to a little bit about vegan options as well as provisions for any cadets who come in with allergies of any kind?
Sure. For vegetarian and vegan options, we have a couple of stations for you. First one is basil, which is the main one that we've had for a while. However, we are expanded throughout this over the summer as far as the menu goes. And now there will be some vegetarian and vegan options that are primarily offered in every single station in the marketplace.
And what about allergies? Can those be handled?
Yeah, if you have a food allergy of any sort and you're not sure or unaware, there's a couple of things you can do. Number one, there is a really great thing called Bite, and it's an app that is free for you to download. And it will allow you to be able to look at all the nutritional information, any kind of allergens or anything of that nature for any one of our items that are made in the marketplace. And it is something that we do advertise. So all the cadets will be able to know about it and be able to get that app downloaded. If you are somebody that is just very, very concerned or have a drastic allergy or anything like that, you are always more than welcome to come talk to me, to talk to Chef Mark, and we can help you walk through some of that those items.
Thank you, Karen. To Travis's pointing out that we have don't have too many water stations, it is true. However, your students are going to be in upper residence hall, which has a water filling station on the first floor. However, for convenience, if they are on, if your student is on the third floor and they want something handy, and that's what Travis was referring to. Travis, correct me if I'm wrong. They could have something in their room, like a few water bottles, if they don't feel like going down the steps to the water station.
I would recommend, in my freshman year, what I ended up getting was like a small little Brita water filter, which I kept in my room. And occasionally, I know a lot of people do it, is, you know, take it down to the little water refilling station, fill that up, and then you will have water for, you know, depending on how much you drink, a couple, you know, a couple days or a day. It's really convenient. Yeah. Cuts down on the amount of steps you have to walk up and down those stairs, because no, if you've been to Cal Maritime, you know you're going to go up and down a lot of stairs.
Hundreds of steps a day.
Cal stair time. That's what we like to call it.
Thank you, Travis. And the next question is, what happens with the dining plan in summer C term semester? Is there a per day amount the cadet will need to be conscious of spending then as well?
Can you repeat that?
Sure. What happens during summer and C term? So essentially they are asking about how food is handled on cruise.
Okay. Cruise is, it's kind of like a whole different little situation. We do support the food service on cruise. Cruise, the way cruise is built, is completely separate than what their meal plan is from the marketplace and here on campus. So it's almost like a two different animals.
So in cruise, everything is included. There isn't a declining balance type of a card, correct?
I don't believe so.
Correct. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So when you pay, when you pay a cruise fee, your entire cruise is included in there. So I hope that answers your question, Danielle. Moving to the next one, could you please restate the weekend hours for food service and confirm that the $26 breakdown is applicable to weekends as well?
Okay. First, the hours for the weekends, we are open from 11 a.m. until 7 p.m. Now, it will switch over from brunch items to dinner items at 4 o'clock. Okay. As far as the spend goes, basically anywhere on campus that has food, all of that is included in that $2,800. So if your cadet goes and they go to the marketplace, they go on weekends, they go to the Morro Cove market, they go to the bistro, there's a food truck that's on campus, there's a special event that where we're doing a hosted happy hour or something of that nature, your declining balance money can be used for all of that.
Just to reiterate that happy hour always makes us think about alcoholic drinks. There is no one, even if you're of age as an upperclassman, you cannot use your DCB card for alcoholic beverages, right?
That's correct. And on a similar note, in the Morro Cove market, there are a few other non-food items in there. For instance, laundry detergent. Those items are available for the cadets because it's items that they might need at a last minute kind of scenario. But those are also not available to be on your taken off of your DCB money. That would be something where a credit card would be necessary.
Thank you, Karen. Is there a limit on how much can be spent in one day?
No. They want to come in and you know, eat $100 worth of food, go for it.
All right. Thank you. Do cadets have small fridges in their room to keep snack items and water bottles? Travis, you want to take that?
Yeah. So you have a small personal fridge that also has a small little freezer on top so you can keep frozen meals. They typically sell that at the marketplace as well in case you're hungry. And the room does include a small microwave that you will share with your roommate as well. So, you know, both that fridge and microwave is also shared by your roommate. So, you know, keep that in mind for any items you buy. Coordinate with your roommate and stuff, reach out to them, message them saying you're getting this. So you're not getting two of everything for that room.
Great, great point. Thank you, Travis. How much room and what resources will cadets have to keep food and drinks in their room? Thank you for answering that already, Travis. Appreciate that. We're back to the $26 a day based on a 5-day week or a 7-day week?
7-day week.
7-day week. Thank you. Those are all the questions. We have someone wanting to reach out to discuss further why at the end of spring monies are not refunded. Will you, Karen, take down Kathy Snow's name and very kindly reach out to Kathy Snow and discuss this further? That's what she'd like to do.
Is Kathy, can you put your contact information
in the chat? Kathy, go ahead and give it to Karen directly instead of putting it to everyone. So those of you who might have joined a few minutes late, I just want to share that today's session and future sessions starting at 5 p.m. Will be recorded and will be posted on our csum.edu website under Keelhauler Family /orientation. So if you just search for Keelhauler Family at csum.edu, you can find those recordings. Please allow 3 to 4 days for us to get the recording uploaded, but they will all be available. If you are interested, ones from last year are also available for viewing in case you are interested. I'm not seeing any more questions show up. So I want to take the time, if I may, to thank our presenters, but I'm forgetting. Is there anyone who was unable to type up their questions in chat and wants to unmute and verbally ask their question because they're driving or for any reason? Okay. Great. With that, if I may, I would like to share a little bit, and I'll do this at the end of every call, discuss a little bit about what to expect on the 21st of August when you arrive here. There are a few things going on, and we want to communicate as much as possible what to expect. The residence life office will send your cadet their exact arrival time. And for today's conversation, I'll just call it 7 a.m. There will be some students who will be given a 7 a.m. Time frame. So 7 a.m., we would like for you to arrive a little early, be able to park in the designated parking lot, and walk over to what we call the Physical Education and Aquatic Center building, which is called PIAC. It's just a hop over from the parking lot. So you would come inside and we'll all be wearing our party hats, ready to welcome you. And we will check your cadet in and they will be guided to go into the basketball gym there to pick up their uniform items. While your student is doing that, we have for you many of our colleagues from different departments collected in the smaller gym for you to connect with them, ask them questions, pick up brochures. Just we're all going to be there bright and early to welcome you, and we'll be there till 2 p.m. You could attend that campus services fair. We have a new inclusion center also in the same building. We invite you to the open house there while your student is picking up their uniforms. Once they're done, they will have a nice load of uniforms in a box that we will provide. And at that time, we will request you to go back to your car in lot O, which is where you would have parked, and then drive up to your designated res hall. So you'll have to remember that you park, you do your fare and pick up your uniform, get back into your car and drive up. So if your time is 7, we're expecting that you will be up at the res hall between 7:30 and 7:40, okay? And once you get there, you hop out of the car, everyone except the driver can come out of the car, unload, and you'll have plenty of cadet leaders helping you through that process. And we will take you into your designated room. And then you can stay there for a little bit of time and get your students set up. And the driver, however, will be sent back to lot O to park, and they can catch a shuttle back to the res hall, or you can have a predetermined time and place to meet. I know this sounds like a lot. It'll come to you in an email, so you know what to do. And I will cover this same process at future calls, so you have an idea. I see that there's a question, but I think that's pretty much how the morning will go. And then at 3 o'clock, the president will do a welcome. And then we have some additional partners from our campus who are going to meet with you in our auditorium to share some information. And after that, we'll have what we call the capping ceremony. After the capping ceremony, you'll be able to go have dinner with your cadet or your student or your kid. You'll come back and drop off your student that night, and that'll be the last time you'll see them for orientation week. They will not have time to meet with you again for the rest of the week. I'm seeing a couple of questions. How do we get our appointment time? You will not get an appointment time. The time will be sent to the student from the Office of Residential Life. This is all a practice for all parents to rely on the students to take charge of how things are gonna go. So these are little baby steps that you will be taking alongside your student to let them take the lead on this. The email will go to the cadets, csum.edu email. They are also receiving newsletters from us at that same email with lots of very important information, and we highly recommend that they go into that mailbox often. No, you cannot get those emails because there's something called FERPA, which prohibits us from sharing information with families and parents. You'll hear more about FERPA in one of our future conversations with financial aid and student financials. So talk to your cadet, get them in the habit of discussing these things with you as on an as needed basis. Any questions about the 21st? You can unmute and ask if it's easier. Great. We are right on time, closing out our session. It's 5:55. And I wanna thank everyone who joined us today to share this information and ask great questions. And just remember, if you haven't already joined us on Facebook, please do that. The closed group on Facebook called Keelhauler Family can be found here. I just posted it again in chat. You do need to give me your student's name and their major in order to be included in this group. And typically I do put updates here for all parents, often photos of students when I see them while I'm walking across campus to say, hey, here's your Waldo. Did you find him or her? So do join the Facebook group. And with that, I want to give a warm round of applause to Karen, Travis, and Scott. Thank you for being here. And I look forward to seeing all of you parents and family members next Tuesday.
Hi, everyone. Can't wait.
Bye-bye.